Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Karen from Fomafung, your Agile Evangelist. In today's video, we will be talking about the kind of questions that a Scrum Master can ask their stakeholders that will help them learn everything they're supposed to know and build trust when they just join a new organization. Yeah, so in the last two videos, we've talked about what a Scrum Master should do when they just join a new team. We've also talked about what a Scrum Master can do or is supposed to do when they just join a new organization. So please, if you missed that video, please go ahead and, you know, click that card above to catch up. Now, what are the kind of questions that a Scrum Master can ask their stakeholders when they just join a new organization? That is those questions that will help them learn everything they're supposed to know, or most of what they're supposed to know about their organization, their stakeholders, and their product, as well as those questions that they can ask that will help them build their trust. So if you are new to this channel, you are most welcome. Please, just so you stay in sync of everything we do here on a weekly basis, go ahead and turn on that subscription button and click that notification bell so you will never miss up on any weekly content. If you also appreciate the content, please go ahead and like, share, drop your comments below in case you have any sort of questions. I will do my best to provide your answers to the best of my ability. Thank you so much. Now, let us get started. What kind of questions can you ask when you just join a new organization that will help you learn most of what you're supposed to know about your organization, about your stakeholders, and about the product you will be working on, as well as those questions that you ask that will help you build trust? So I have three categories of suggestions. I have suggestions for questions that you want to ask your stakeholders, that's the extended stakeholders. I also have categories of questions that you want to ask someone who is very knowledgeable about the product you will be working on, or the project you will be working on if your organization is a project-based organization. Like a typical example of that kind of person would be the PO or whoever has a solid knowledge about that product or the project. The third category of question that I have as suggestion is those questions that you'd want to ask your core team members that will help you understand a lot about the team, such as the team dynamics and so on. So now let us start with the questions that you want to ask your stakeholders that will help you learn about your organization from the big picture standpoint. A good place to always start is to, you know, set the stage with an icebreaker. So there are a lot of ideas out there on internet where you can get really good icebreakers that you can go ahead and start with that will help, you know, warm up the atmosphere so people, you know, you're just getting to know each other. So your stakeholder can get comfortable with talking to you and sharing information so you can really leverage that moment to learn most of what you're supposed to know. So go ahead, launch your icebreaker. And once the icebreaker is done, I highly suggest you go ahead and start to introduce your own self. So the very first thing you want to understand is the role of your stakeholder, or the accountability of your stakeholder on the product or the project you're working on. So you ask something like this. So what role or accountability do you have on the product or the project I am working on? They'll go ahead and tell you. The second question you want to ask them is, what area would you both be collaborating on? You know, that question is also very important because it helps you figure out what kind of communication you will need to roll up to your stakeholder, or what kind of communication you need to get from your stakeholder that will help you add value to your business and to your customer. The third question you would like to ask is, ask them what their expectation of you is. So you ask something like this. So what are you expecting, or what are you hoping I'll bring to the organization? That's something you want to ask. They'll go ahead and tell you so that you know as you're preparing to, you know, deliver value and make everyone happy. Another thing you would like to find out from your stakeholder is if there are any immediate pain points that they are going through, and you also want to find out if there is any way you can help to fix those pain points. So you ask something like this: are there any immediate pain points that you are currently going through, and what can I do to help? That's something you like to know. So another question you want to ask is, who are your external stakeholders? That is in terms of vendors, customers, like end users, directors, CEOs, and people like that. You want to ask, it will be very important for you to find out who those people are, so that you know how you're coming into to set up that cross-functional collaboration, because it's also really important for you to have that information. So yes, so that's another thing you would like to find out. So you also want to find out, among those external stakeholders, who are those that will be beneficial for you to get to know? Yes, that's how you get to generate your list of the people or the stakeholders that you will have to be collaborating with throughout your stay in the organization. Yeah, so when you meet a stakeholder, you have this conversation, you keep adding to your list, you keep adding, and that's how you, at the end of the day, you generate that list that you have to come up with a plan on how you want to meet them and talk with them and gather information from them. Yeah, so when your stakeholder provides the name of your external stakeholders, you want to go ahead and also ask them, among these external stakeholders, who are those that are, it will be beneficial for me to get to know? That's something you also want to find out. Now, a very important point that you would like to find out is what their perception is as far as agile transformation is concerned in the organization. Yes, so you ask something like this. So what is your perception with agile transformation in the organization? That's from the organization standpoint, not at team level, because you know, any organization that has gone through transformation, and if the transformation is not coming from the top, you will face a lot of challenges. So that's something that's important for you to get to know, so that you're knowing how you're strategizing and how you're coming in to help the organization and your team. Yes, that's something you like to know. And now you want to find out about what their organizational vision is. That is the business vision. What you are doing, how the project or the product you'll be working on, how does it sink into the business vision? That's something you also want to understand. Yes. So you'll be asking your stakeholder what the vision of the business is, what the mission of the business is, and what their strategies are. That's something you also want to find out. Another thing you want to find out is how effective, you want to ask their perception on how effective, you know, Scrum practice is at team level. You know, and the information they'll be providing to you, I am hoping it's not just going to be from their feelings or feel say, it's going to be from data, the data they've been collecting all along. You want to ask them, if possible, if they can show you the data, you know, for you to understand how effective Scrum practice is in that organization, it will be very helpful, so that way you can identify areas of improvement and determine how you want to come in and help the organization. Now, the last but not the least information you want to get from your stakeholder is, you want to find out if there are any resistant stakeholders. It's also very good to know the stakeholders that might potentially be resistant to Agile and to Scrum, so that way you are figuring out how you want to approach them in a way that you will easily get buy-in from them. That's something you want to find out. Yeah, so those are my suggestions for the questions you would want to ask your stakeholders that will help you provide information that will get you going from the organizational standpoint. Now, the second category of questions that I suggest you ask is from the product standpoint, that is you trying to learn more about the product. A good person, a good go-to person for this kind of information would be someone who is very knowledgeable about the product, like the product owner or the technical lead or whoever has good information about the product that they're producing. So my suggestions for the kind of questions you want to ask is, the very first thing is, you want to ask your that stakeholder to walk you through the product roadmap. That's the first thing you want to find out. The second thing you want to ask them is, you want to ask them to help, you know, educate you about the product vision. you also want to ask them to help walk you through the product goal. You know, in the new Scrum Guide, the updated version of the 2020 Scrum Guide states that the Scrum team is now accountable for the product goal, not just the sprint goal, not just the increment. They are now accountable for the product goal. So it will be beneficial for you to ask someone who is very knowledgeable about the product to help inform you about what the product goal should be. You also want to ask them what the success criteria are and how do they know if the team has actually achieved the outcome, if they've actually achieved the outcome, if they've actually delivered to the customers as expected. How do they get feedback from the customers? That's something you want to ask. These are the kind of questions that you want to ask your stakeholder, that is the product owner or whoever has a solid knowledge about that product. Another thing you want to find out is you want to ask something like this: how does stories get into the backlog? Who is responsible in writing stories? Who is responsible in writing sprints goal? Those are the kind of questions you want to ask. You also want to ask them, what is the typical age of a user story in the backlog? That's something you want to ask them as well. Yeah. Yeah. The other thing you want to ask your product owner is whether the product backlog usually contains stories or items that none of the team members are aware of. That's something you want to ask, or even the product owner. You want to find out if the backlog usually contains stories or work items that he is not familiar with or he is not aware of. Another thing you want to ask is, you want also find out from your product owner, how often do they refine their product backlog? That's something you want to ask. So you also want to ask something like, so where are you discussing stories? You know, because we have all these various Scrum events, we have other optional events, but it will be very helpful if you understand where the team has agreed to discuss their user stories. Is it during release planning? Is it during PI planning? Is it during, backlog refinement? Is it during planning? That's something that you would like to understand. Yeah, so some other important aspects that you want to find out is, you want to ask them if they apply a definition of ready. You also want to ask them if they apply a definition of done. And if so, you also want to ask them what are the criteria of their definition of done and the definition of ready. What are the components that make up their definition of done and their definition of ready? What do they go by to be able to establish those definition of done and definition of ready? That's something that will be very important for you to find out as well. Another thing that you also want to ask is, you also want to find out the estimation technique and how it's been working for them. So you want to ask the product owner, what's their current estimation technique? Why they decided to start using that estimation technique? What are the challenges they've been facing with that estimation technique? And what are the benefits they've been, acquiring from using that estimation technique? That's something you also want to find out from your PO. And one other thing too, which is something I'll ask all my stakeholders, is what their perception of Agile is within the organization and within the team, as well as their perception of the practice of Scrum in the organization and at team level. That's something you also want to find out from your product owner. You know, you asking all this information, I'm very sure that it's going to give you a very good base for you to start off with. And then another very important point that you want to find out is, you also want to ask your product owner about what their expectation of you is. You also want to ask them if there are any current pain points and what can you do to help, fix those pain points. That's something you want to find out from your product owner that will help you gain more insight about the product or the project that you will be working on. Now, the last category of questions that you will be asking is the question that is designed for the core team members. The first thing you want to find out from your core team members is, again, go ahead and introduce yourself, starting with an icebreaker. That's always a good place to start. And then you go ahead first by asking, you know, what their expectation of you is. What are they hoping you would bring to the team that will add value? That's something you want to ask. You want to ask to understand their current process as far as, you know, executing their work is concerned. You want to ask about the challenges they've been facing with their current process. You want to ask about how the current process have been working for them, how it's been benefiting them. That's something you also want to ask. You also want to ask your team members what their perception of Agile is, what their understanding of Agile is, and what they feel about it. That's just what I mean by their perception of Agile. That's something you want to ask them. Most of the time, for you to determine where a team member is with Agile, you'd find team members, when you're asking them about Agile, they start talking about the Agile frameworks. They'll start talking about Scrum. They'll start talking about Kanban. That's where you understand that, oh yeah, here you have some work to do. Because if they had that understanding, they would know that Agile is the whole mindset and behavior aspect. It's not about the Agile frameworks. It's about the Agile mindset. So that's something you want to observe and make sure that you are catching. Another important aspect you want to find out from your stakeholder is, I mean your core team member, what their role or their accountability is in the Scrum team. What is their strength? I mean, in terms of skill set, what role do they play exactly to contribute to the value adding of the team and to their customers? That's something you want to find out as well. Another important point you want to find out from your core team members that will help you determine if you have to go back and start repairing the foundation is, you want to find out if they already have some set of ground rules that is governing their team. That's something you want to find out. If there are no ground rules that is governing their working, yes, you want to go back and collaborate with them to build a team charter that will help set rules of engagement, that will help clearly set rules of communication and things like that. Another aspect that you want to capture in that team charter is, first, you want to ask your core team members what the product vision is. This question will help you, will tell you whether your team members are just working on things or they are working on a purpose. That's something you want to ask. If they cannot give you a clear, if they cannot clearly tell you what the product vision is, then that's when you will know that your team members are just working on accomplishing output instead of outcome. So if your team members don't have the understanding on what the product vision is, it's your responsibility to help them carve out the product vision, you know, find out who has that information. And on your team charter, you're capturing that information on your team charter. And together as a team, you people are building that team charter. That way it will help your core team members connect to the purpose, the reason why they are doing what they are doing, and how what they are doing is impacting the big picture. That's something that you like to do, because laying that solid foundation will make your life easy as a Scrum Master as well, because it's going to increase motivation, it's going to increase commitment. You know, just knowing how your input is contributing to the big picture is very, very powerful. So that's something you also want to find out from your core team members. Another thing you want to find out from your core team members is what the expectation of you is. You want to ask them what they are hoping you would bring to the team, what they are hoping you would add to the team. You know, that's something that you also want to find out from your core team members. Another thing you want to find out from them is, like I suggested earlier, this question is something you ask all your stakeholders. You want to ask them what their perception of the Agile transformation from the organization standpoint is. You want to ask that. And then you also want to ask them to rate the Scrum practice within their team. You also want to ask them that. And then another thing you want to ask them is, ask them to give you some ideas on whether you might encounter some resistant team members, and what would be the common reason why those team members would resist if they are aware of it. You know, so you want to ask, find out those kind of information, because it's important for you to have that information so that you will come up with a really, you know, captivating strategy on how to approach those potential resistant team members. So that's the kind of information that you want to ask your core team members. So in summary, those are the three categories of questions that you want to find out from your stakeholders that will help you understand the organization, your stakeholders, that is both external and core team members, that will help you understand the product, and that you understanding all this information, it will help you really learn and build trust, build that relationship. So that's something you would want to be asking. Now we are going to end here today. Thank you so much for watching this session. Please, if you have any questions, go to the comment section and drop your questions. Yeah, please don't forget to turn on that subscription button and the notification bell so that you stay in sync of our weekly upload. Also, go ahead and like, share, drop your comments so that we all can continue to learn and grow as this one big, happy, agile family. Thank you so much and hope to talk to you another time. Bye.